The aid workers and emergency responders gathering in the central Mozambican city of Brno know exactly what to do when hundreds of thousands of people lack basic necessities like food, shelter and clean water. The problem in Mozambique is getting the aid to the people who need it. Helicopters and light aircraft are the only practical way to move supplies in this part of the country because main roads and secondary thoroughfares have been washed out, or lie under meters of dirty, brown floodwater. However, there are simply not enough helicopters to do the job. I spoke to one highly regarded search and rescue organization who said they are going home because they cannot get the transport they need. The team from the World Food Program have access to a Soviet-era chopper and we flew with them as they prepared to deliver family-sized tents, emergency meals and medicines to the people of a community called Nhomatanda. First, we had to cross the giant inland sea that has been created by Cyclone Idai as well as 5 or so days of torrential rain, and we soon realized that the precipitation has not stopped. Our captain deftly steered around thunderclouds and rain showers as we headed to our destination in the northwest. The weather wasn't the only complication. Nhomatanda is surrounded by floodwater and the pilots were struggling to find it. The water had swallowed up all the landmarks on their maps. With fuel running low, the crew had little choice and they decided to return to base. This is an occupation hazard in a disaster zone and the crew took it in their stride, equipping themselves with a new set of coordinates and taking off once more for Nhomatanda. This time we found it and I could see several residents standing on an ad hoc landing zone waving homemade flags.